Hi, everyone. It's Rena Jadavan. I'm so excited. We have some hot news today on the heart health front. And here to tell us all about it is Dr. Joel Kahn. Hi, Dr. Joel. Welcome.
Oh, good day, everybody. Hot, hot, hot news, literally.
So as I understand, some of us get stuck in a rut, right? And we're eating right and we're doing everything we can. We're working out and it's not working. And Dr. Joel, you've got some great news for those of us stuck in a rut. What can we do to get out of it?
Stuff. You know, I really like to recommend things that have scientific basis. Mm-hmm. But a lot of us are trying to eat well, trying to get some exercise, trying to sleep, you know, trying to manage stress. Maybe we've switched from plastic bottles to glass water bottles because we know that the environment's full of thousands of things attacking our health, chemicals of all kinds. But we're still stuck. So it turns out one of the most enjoyable things you can do, which is take a sauna, has had quite a bit of data, but it's getting stronger and stronger and easier to access. So real quickly, and you might say, did he just say sauna? Yes, I said sauna. S-A-U-N-A. There has been, I learned about 5 years ago about a body of data in the medical science literature from Japan, all papers translated to English. If you're a sick heart patient with bad arteries or congestive heart failure or high blood pressure or bad blockages in your legs, they are very keen on a kind of sauna called infrared sauna. That's available throughout the world. You can find health clubs, you can find some wellness centers, or you can get one yourself. We have a chain in Detroit of massage centers that have really high-end infrared sauna units that you can rent by the hour, buy a package. So it turns out spending 30 minutes in an infrared sauna a few times a week, according to the Japanese data, promotes the chance that your blood pressure will improve, that you'll lose weight. It's really interesting. They've done studies that if you exercise and you're sweating and somebody comes up to you and grabs a couple drops of sweat and analyzes it, you actually help to get rid of toxins that may have built up in your body from food, from air, from dirty water when you sweat. So it turns out they're even more concentrated in the sweat when you're in a sauna. It doesn't mean stop exercising, but exercise, and when you can grab some time, this is all data from an infrared sauna, because you may actually be cleaning out your body and get past that rut. That may be what it takes to start seeing you return to some weight loss, return to feeling more energy, return to helping with brain fog. Maybe your joints don't hurt as much. All those things have actually been demonstrated with sauna.
That's right.
So not everybody, however, can find or access or maybe, of course, afford to buy an infrared sauna for their home, which can range from under $1,000 to spending $4,000 or $5,000 for the bells and whistle infrared sauna that's going to last you, you know, several decades. But that's a sizable financial investment, a very wonderful financial investment. I have one in my home. I use it regularly. Absolutely love it. Very calming, very relaxing, at the same time therapeutic. So the new hot news on top of that amazing foundation is a series of research papers coming out of Finland. Finland, they don't do infrared sauna. They do hot steam sauna. Mm-hmm. And most people can say, well, I have a health club I used to belong to. I do belong to a community center, a senior center. They have that hot steam sauna. And it turns out you got to be a little cautious. The temperature of a hot steam sauna can be quite a bit higher than infrared. Infrared tends to be maybe 120 to 130 degrees. Steam sauna can easily be 180. And all those signs about if you're pregnant, if you're frail, if you have a pacemaker, there's some reality to all that. Although again, in Japan, they use infrared sauna in very sick heart patients, but that's that little cooler temperature. So this Finnish data has shown, if you want to know how long you're going to live in Finland, just ask the question, how many times a week you're getting the steam sauna and how many minutes each time? It's a linear relationship to survival.
Wow.
If you want to avoid high blood pressure, how many times a week, how many minutes a week in a steam sauna? Boom, low blood pressure from sauna. Recently, inflammation they've been studying. That if you have either lab values that show inflammation called your high sensitivity C-reactive protein, or if you just feel it, your joints are swollen, your joints are red, you know, you're dealing with something. Of course, look at your diet, think about what you can take out of your diet, think about what you can add like ginger and garlic and turmeric and such. But steam sauna has been shown to lower the C-reactive protein level, as has infrared sauna both. Finally and recently, both these saunas, but new data in the steam sauna, the issue of memory. There's some absolutely interesting data coming out of Finland that your chance of being an adult with the best memory intact goes just linearly with how many times a week and how many minutes each time you get in the steam sauna. So which do you do? And nobody has direct comparison. It's really, what can you access? If you can either afford or access an infrared sauna, go for it. It's a little cooler temperature and probably more appropriate for frailer people. If you have only access to a steam sauna and a health club, enjoy it not just for the social aspect, or maybe there's some lavender in the air like the one that I have in my health club. It's just a nice place to sit. But realize that as you're sweating, you're really promoting getting out of the rut, getting back on track, getting to a point where you're starting to regain your health. So that's the hot news, that this enjoyable pastime is actually a cardiology treatment that in Japan is considered routine, and in Finland is considered routine as a treatment. In the United States, it'd still be very uncommon to hear a cardiologist like I am talk about using this as a primary treatment of heart disease, but it's the real deal. These are big studies.
Thank you so much for sharing that. It sounds like a dream, because who doesn't enjoy a nice sit out in the sauna? I actually have an infrared in my home, and oh, I use it a lot. So quick question for you there, Dr. Joel. How many minutes and how many days a week do you recommend?
Yeah, so the Japanese protocol, most of the time this is 30 minutes or less.
Okay.
Actually, the Japanese protocol is just 15 minutes three times a week. These are a little bit more frail elderly heart patients. And you know, you want to be a little cautious about rehydrating afterwards with some water, but that's about a typical. And in Finland, there's no specific protocol, but it's about 30 minutes in a unit. And certainly, if you're frail, ease into it. Go slow. Take 5 or 10 minutes. Make sure you're not dizzy. Make sure you're breathing okay. Drink some water after cool down. So this being maybe if you've been working out a little bit, it's a nice thing to do at the end of an exercise routine. There's some data that muscle soreness can be treated with sauna.
Those of us that sometimes get carried away and do a little more. Well, what's the upper limit? Can you do it 5 days a week, 6 days a week? And yeah, can you do it?
Oh, you're a young woman and in good health at this point because you've done so much for your health. No, I think it can become a daily habit. And particularly if there's a therapeutic goal. I've got a weight goal, a blood pressure goal. I've got an inflammation goal. Daily basis on a health maintenance program, you know, 2-3 times a week is probably more, you know, time efficient.
That sounds great. Thank you so much, Dr. Joel. And for the rest of you, invest in a sauna. I swear by it. We'll see you on another one of these soon. Thank you, Dr. Joel.
Bye-bye. Thank you.